My name's Graham Roberts. I look after Central Queensland area, and today I'd like to give you some insight into droplet size for dust suppression in underground mines. The droplet size is very critical when considering dust suppression, especially in underground mines, due to a number of factors. One of the main ones being ventilation they have in their underground pits. Some of the factors influencing droplets are the pressure at the nozzle, the type of nozzle, and also the capacity of the nozzle being used or trialled. Some of the rules of thumbs for reducing or increasing droplet size are larger capacity, the larger the droplet, or higher the pressure, the smaller the droplet size. When the ventilation is usually around velocity of 75 to 85 cubic meters per second and 3.5 to 4.5 meters per second speed, there is a huge effect on what the droplet size will do within the mine site. So we have to get the correct nozzle selection and the correct application. And this must be for the droplet size and the pressure that is being used. Within Queensland at the moment, there is a huge problem with black lung disease. Now, this is a deadly disease, and droplet size is very critical to try and prevent the black lung disease, or the particle size that has an effect on black lung is usually about less than 30 microns. Some of the main applications for dust suppression and dust prevention in underground mines are transfer points, roadways, main gate, BSL, pan lines, crushers, roof supports, and shearer. There are also a number of applications that need attention on the surface for these underground mines, and these include ROM bins, sieve bins, chutes, froth knockdown, thickeners, and a number of screens. These are in the main where the coal is being transferred to the prep plant for washing and screening. All have a number of different types of nozzles and can use our complete range of hydraulic nozzles and some of our atomizing versions in most of these applications. So from point of view of droplet size, I believe I've just given you some insight into how it is required and what we need to look at in coal mine underground mining.